Hey, it's me, GV, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, ladies and gentlemen. In the last episode, we were delving through Snowvale Sanctum with Mercer Frey, who has proven to be a pretty big help. I mean, he's an asshole, he's not that great of a guy, he's a douchebag, but he swings a strong sword, definitely. He's been helping me out with the DPS, which reminds me, to get that extra DPS, we're going to switch back to Bound Battle Axe in our right hand and Conjure Flame Atronach in our left. Don't really do a lot of damage, but it's the only way really that we can increase our conjuration, which is actually not true, because like I said in the last episode, if we have Muffle in our right hand, and if we have Soul Trap in our left hand, we can do this. Muffle, Soul Trap, Muffle, Soul Trap, Muffle, Soul Trap, and you guys get how it goes, especially if you just wait 24 hours until you have Highborn again. You can just constantly do this, and this is the extent of what I will do in a in any playthrough, whether it's on YouTube or whether it's just for fun off camera. I'll never use exploits, duplication glitches, console commands, cheats like that. Completely ruins the experience for me. But this way, you know, this is just in the parameters of the game. It works. So I'm going to do this until illusion increases one more time, just because I'm really finding it hard to find when I will be able to do this. I'm literally just gonna have to take like 10 minutes and do this constantly until I raise both illusion and conjuration up until 100 off camera. Just take 10 minutes and do this constantly, because that's really the only time I have to do it, which is why I'm doing it here, so at least I can get a little bit out of it before you guys riot and absolutely hate this and comment that you've done this too much. But like I said, we're doing this until illusion increases one more time, because it's gonna go a far way into leveling us up. I'm surprised it hasn't happened already. I mean, our illusion is pretty high, so obviously it takes a lot longer now. Come on. It's gotta be the next one or two, though, I promise. Conjuration is increasing pretty fast, though, of course. There we go. Our illusion is 78 now. Alright, so we are going to, again, grab Bound Battle Axe and Conjure Flame Atronach, and we are going to move on. We're attempting to find Carlaya, the worst betrayer of the Thieves Guild that has ever lived, apparently. Here, Mercer, let me go ahead and disarm these. Did Carlaya really think that thieves as adept as us would fall into a bear trap? Come on now.
Ah, it's one of the infamous Nordic puzzle doors. How quaint. Without the matching claw, they're normally impossible to open. Since I'm certain Carlaya already did away with it, we're on our own. Fortunately, these doors have a weakness. We know how to exploit it. Quite simple, really. Carlaya's close, I'm certain of it. Now let's get moving.
Huh. You know, Mercer, I looked through the lockpicking tree. I didn't see anything anywhere saying that I could pick the locks of these Nordic puzzle doors.
Your heart.
Give me a reason to try.
You're a clever girl, Carlaya. Buying Golden Glow Estate and funding Haunting Brew Meadery was inspired.
To ensure an enemy's defeat, you must first undermine his allies. It was the first lesson Gallus taught us.
You always were a quick study.
Not quick enough, otherwise Gallus would still be alive.
Gallus had his wealth and he had you. All he had to do was look the other way.
Did you forget the oath we took as Nightingales? Did you expect him to simply ignore your methods?
Enough of this mindless banter. Come, Carlaya. It's time for you and Gallus to become reunited.
I'm no fool, Mercer. Crossing blades with you would be a death sentence. But I can promise the next time we meet, it will be your undoing.
How interesting. It appears Gallus' history has repeated itself. Carlia has provided me the means to be rid of you, and this ancient tomb becomes your final resting place. But do you know what intrigues me the most? The fact that this was all possible because of you. Farewell. I'll be certain to give Brynjolf your regards.
And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching Let's Play Skyrim. It's been a wild ride from start to finish. Absolutely amazing. I love each and every one of you. Just kidding.
Easy. Easy. Don't get up so quickly. How are you feeling?
Hold on. You shot me.
No. I saved your life. My arrow was tipped with a unique paralytic poison. It slowed your heart and kept you from bleeding out. Had I intended to kill you, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Why save me?
My original intention was to use that arrow on Mercer. But I never had a clear shot. I made a split-second decision to get you out of the way, and it prevented your death.
Why should I believe you?
Without the antidote I administered, you'd be as still as a statue. I treated your wounds and didn't leave you defenseless. The poison on that arrow took me a year to perfect. I only had enough for a single shot, and yet I used it on you. All I had hoped was to capture Mercer alive.
Why capture Mercer alive?
Mercer must be brought before the guild to answer for what he's done. He needs to pay for Gallus's murder.
How will you prove it now?
My purpose in using Snowvale Sanctum to ambush Mercer wasn't simply for irony's sake. Before both of you arrived, I recovered a journal from Gallus's remains. I suspect the information we need is written inside.
Well, what's it say?
I wish I knew. The journal is written in some sort of language I've never seen before.
Perhaps it could be translated.
Enther. Gallus's friend at the College of Winterhold. Of course. It's the only outsider Gallus trusted with the knowledge of his Nightingale identity.
There's that word again, Nightingale.
There were three of us. Myself, Gallus, and Mercer. We were an anonymous splinter of the Thieves Guild in Riften. Perhaps I'll tell you more about it later. Right now, you need to head for Winterhold with the journal and get the translation. Here, take these as well. They may prove useful for your journey.
Gallus's encoded journal and potent frenzy poison. It's not gonna be useful for my journey, but thanks. I mean, it's the thought that counts. Why didn't you kill Mercer? Well, we know why she didn't kill Mercer, right? Why didn't you kill Mercer?
Mercer lied to the guild, branded me a murderer, and slandered my name across his network of contacts. For 25 years, I ran, never sleeping in the same place twice and carefully covering my tracks. Mercer doesn't need to die. He needs to feel the cold sting of fate as his life crumbles in front of him and he's hunted by the guild.
Might not have a choice next time.
I can promise you if it comes to that, and my back's to the wall, I won't hesitate. Remember, speak only to Enther. Trust no one else.
So, big revelation here, ladies and gentlemen. Now you're probably seeing why the Thieves Guild is actually my favorite guild. Is it my favorite guild? Have I mentioned? No, the College of Winterhold. I don't know. It changes depending on what I'm playing. We're going to go ahead and go to the College of Winterhold now. Obviously, we need to speak with Enthir. Why is it telling me to go? Oh, I guess he's in one of the inns. Yes, Mercer Frey. Not only is he an asshole, a terrible person, really begrudgingly. No, curmudgeonly, right? That's the word that no one ever uses. He also actually murdered Gallus, betrayed the Thieves Guild, and the only people that know are myself and Carlia. So we need to expose him, obviously, and dethrone him as guild leader. Let's head into the Frozen Hearth, one of the areas you don't usually explore too much because the College of Winterhold doesn't have a lot to offer.
Like some horrible monster was turned inside out. Yes, yes, what is it?
Oh my god, why would they do that? I must have known that before, but they used the same voice actor for Mercer Frey as the guy that we have to talk to right after finding Mercer Frey is the traitor. I've been sent by Carlyle.
Carlyle? Then she's finally found it. Do you have Gallus's journal?
Why would they do that? That's so immersion-breaking. Yes, but there's a problem.
A problem? Let me see it. Oh, this is just like Gallus. A dear friend, but always too clever for his own good. He's written all of the text in the Falmer language.
Can you translate it?
No. However, I know someone who might. The court wizard of Markarth, Calselmo, may have the materials you need to get this journal translated. Word of warning, Calselmo is a fierce guardian of his research. Getting the information won't be easy.
So I'm not sure if we've had a brush with the Falmer yet. Does Adrenok know of what the Falmer... I feel like because they are a type of mer or elf, he would know what they are. So I'm not going to ask. And yeah. Like I said in the stream, usually when I read these, I think, would Adrenok want to know? I mean, his ultimate goal is ultimate power, as we all know. Would he want to know about this stuff? I don't think so.
Calselmo is stubborn as a mule. Be careful when you speak to him.
Greetings, Archmage.
Oh, who is that? Nelikar? Nelikar? Oh, there's a side quest, I think, with Nelikar. I'm not remembering. I know we have something to do with Nelikar at some point. What's going on here? Who are you? Oh, it's always vampires. Why do I even ask? All right, so we need to head over to Markarth. We have seen Calselmo before. I'm not sure if we've talked to him. But we will. And we need to get Gallus's journal decoded. Come on. There we go. So Calselmo is the court wizard, I think was his title. He's in the Understone Keep, which is where we have fast traveled to. Inside we go. And he's also by one of the coolest areas in Skyrim. I think I've mentioned this before. I'm not exactly sure, but that little river area where I used to always go to disenchant things, make potions, and then drop all of my trash into that, I don't know, brook, river, whatever you would call it. It's running through a building, or I guess a dwarven city, so it's odd. I guess it's a river.
What are you doing here? The excavation site is closed. I don't need any more workers or guards.
I was looking for you, actually.
I told you I'm not hiring any more guards. Why do you people always bother me when I'm trying to finish my research? You idiot! Do you even know who I am? The most recognized scholar on the Dwemer in all of Tamriel. And you people keep bothering me. I'm sorry, I got too excited. I'm in the middle of some very stressful work, and I shouldn't have yelled. How can I help you?
No, you shouldn't have yelled, and you're raising Adrenok's anger by quite a bit. I would be careful of my words, old man. I hear you're the authority on ancient Falmor. Falmer, not Falmor.
Then you were well informed. I am at this very moment on the cusp of completing my magnum opus on the subject. I'm calling it Calselmo's Guide to the Falmer Tongue. It will revolutionize the way we understand those ancient beings.
Perhaps I could view your work?
Preposterous. That research represents years of personal toil in some of the most dangerous Dwemer ruins in Skyrim. You must be mad to think I'd allow anyone to see it before it's completed.
Grant me access or you'll regret it.
Do you realize that at a snap of my fingers, I can bring the entire Markarth City Guard to my defense? You best rethink this course of action, or you may find yourself on the executioner's block.
But I'm a great admirer of your work.
While I appreciate the sentiment, I still have to decline. Being an admirer, I'm sure you can appreciate the need to keep my research a secret.
What will it cost to change your mind?
I'm not certain how many scholars you're accustomed to dealing with, but I can assure you that personal wealth is our lowest priority.
So it's another Gollum Eye situation where either you have to have a very high level of speech or perks or whatever, or You just have to do it the hard way. And we don't, so forget it. Maybe I'll come back later.
Very well. Perhaps when my research is complete, I'll feel more comfortable discussing my findings with you.
Or perhaps I'll just steal them. Optional, obtain the key to Calselmo's museum. Hey, look how easy this is. Don't mind if I do. Alright. So, before we actually go to the museum, if you could go ahead and get off of this, please. Thank you. I'm more important than you, you understand. Do we have anything to disenchant? Indeed, we do. The Circlet of Illusion. Illusion spells cost 15% less to cast. And there we go. Alright, we could also create some potions, but as this Let's Play goes on, I'm realizing that there's not really that much of a point. I'll do it every time we go back to our makeshift house in court. Riverwood.
The Dwemer Museum isn't open to anyone without the court wizard's permission.
Okay, so it doesn't matter what we pick. Why can't I go in?
Because Calselmo doesn't want anyone to go in. He runs the museum. He makes the rules. You have a problem with that? Go talk to him. You'll find him in front of the ruins during the day, just down the tunnel.
You know what I just realized? We have the absolute best spell for this. I don't think we can dual cast it still. It costs too much magic, but see you later? Stop! Who are you talking to? I just completely disappeared, my friend. Alright, so if you guys didn't watch the live stream, basically how the invisibility spell works is once it's activated, whenever you activate something, like the Dwemer Museum, it immediately deactivates, which is okay, because as soon as you tap A, you go into a loading screen, so I don't think it matters too much. But from here on out, we want to be invisible, basically, and that's what we will do. I am honestly extremely glad we were able to grab this spell.
Calselmo called it his entire expedition. Said he needed every man to get him to take the risk.
And I think it lasts 30 seconds, but I need to make sure so I don't screw myself over. 30 seconds. Yes, activating an object or attacking will break the spell. So we just need to remember to keep casting it.
We lost 3 good men to the traps. And for what? Just to see another damn spider tank around. Well, at least this post is safe enough. Come on, let's get back to it.
And as long as we remain not in combat, as long as we remain passive. Oh shit! No one's trespassing here. I totally forgot something. I totally forgot when you activate something, it ruins it. For instance,
you have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense?
I say I'd rather die than go to prison. But just kidding. I'm gonna reload that. Hopefully, that autosave. Yes, indeed. All right. So I totally forgot that when you activate something, it. It's not like I forgot. It's just that. Well, I forgot. There's no better way to say it than that. Alright, so as they're talking, we're going to hopefully go over here. We also have a potion of invisibility, which will last past activations, I believe. So, okay, that's good. Close the gate. Go invisible. Obviously, over here, we have another Stone of Baron Zaya. Oh, I keep forgetting, see? Yeah, it's because the only invisibility I ever utilizes from potions which keep you invisible. Alright, let's try opening this. Ah, I know I've said it a billion times, but it just sucks so much when you don't have any lock picking skills. Expert and master are pretty tough. Come on. Come on. Delicate as a flower. There we go. Okay. And look at that. Nothing. Now, I believe I said that really. What? I forgot again. Damn it. Alright. Have to remember to stop doing that. It's really weird because you can continue to cast invisibility as well. And that doesn't count as an activation, which is kind of stupid in my opinion, but okay. If we ever have to activate a bunch of stuff and we know that the guards will figure us out, we will simply use a potion of invisibility. I believe I have at least one. Oh, I forgot again. Why is this so difficult? Jeez, alright, we don't want to step on that because it's going to, obviously, spawn a blade trap. If I remember right, this should be the location that has something very, very, very unique in it. In fact, it has to be. I would assume that because this costs a lot more magicka, it's increasing our illusion at a faster rate than casting muffled, but I could be wrong also. I'm not sure, but man, once you get invisibility as a mage, the world is your oyster. It just really is. It's really nice. Like, this is a level of play that I've never been at before. I've never had the invisibility spell. Never been able to cast it, as you can probably imagine, considering I never play mages, and it's already using more than half of our magicka just to cast it with one hand. Okay, here it is. So, as I'm sure most of you know, we have the spider control rod. And that spider is actually not hostile towards us. Here we have a Contar's lab journal. Icontar's, however you want to pronounce it. Let's see how long it is. I seem to remember it's pretty long. Yeah. It's pretty long indeed. It's describing the spider rod, spider control rod that we just found. I'm going to let you pause the video if you want and read these pages. But basically, well, I'll show you. Okay, there you go. Well, I won't show you because you know what? It's not really that crazy. Basically, you point where you want the spider to go and it goes there, and then it attacks any enemies. So you can basically just control it. A bunch of people are probably wanting me to show. But the thing is, they'll realize... Okay, I'll just show you guys how it moves. Okay, spider control rod directs Icontar's spider to the target, right? So, as you can probably tell, charge it up, launch it in an area, and the spider moves. Isn't that amazing? Wow. Absolutely amazing. I don't really understand the point too much. Okay, let's not get found out. You know, we should use Muffle too. Yeah, I don't know why I haven't been doing this. So, Muffle and Invisibility. Invisibility! Alright, so we already found the spider control rod. And it's not like it's gonna... Oh, is it? Okay, it actually is gonna kill the wizard's guard. I've never found this really to be important. Jeez. But honestly, I guess I just thought the whole time that it was a normal dwarven spider, but it looks like it has increased stats or something. Whoa! Okay, that's okay. They're wizard guards, so we can kill them. Alright, we'll let the spider take it on. In the meantime, we will go towards our objective. This door is barred from the other side, really. Okay. So I guess from here on out, we don't have to remain in sneak. Also, can we turn this? What is the point of that? How would we ever turn that and then get into this position? I don't know. There's another one over here, though. What just happened there? I'm not even sure what this thing is. It's like a blade trap, I guess? You rarely, and I said half of those weird because I said them in quick succession. See that. I don't even remember ever seeing that. Alright, so I think we'll just sneak past them. Usually when I do the Thieves Guild in video games, I like to play as a thief. Just can't touch them. And bye-bye. For the longest time, I was under the impression that... I forget what I was saying, but we'll continue on here. Oh, we could activate the trap, obviously, is what that whole dialogue is supposed to be telling us. But I'm not sure where the activation floor plate is, probably. Oh, what I was saying was when I play the Thieves Guild, usually what I like to do... Is not kill everybody, but you know what? Sometimes it's fun to just kill them. This person's just contemplating the death that she... Are you going to walk right into the blade, miss? I don't know what she's doing. Okay, so it's telling us to go in this direction, and yeah, she just literally walked into the blade. AI, man! AI. Isn't it a wonderful thing? But what I've been trying to say is that when I play through the Thieves Guild, whether it's Oblivion or Skyrim or what have you, I usually like to not kill anybody because, you know, the Thieves Guild usually frowns on killing, although the leader is Mercer Frey, who, of course, has done his fair share of killing. But it's just nice to not be able to have to kill somebody for once. All right, so this is going to be a little tricky here. Maybe not. Never saw a thing. But yeah, this is really cool. This is a unique style of gameplay that I've never really done before. Really interesting. This makes me want to play like a sneak mage. Oh my god! Oh, it's happening. And I'm sorry, I didn't really get a front row seat. Oh, who's that? Ikentar. Ooh, interesting. Alright, well, we're gonna keep going here. No one needs to leave. You can't see me, I'm invisible. Alright, into the Markarth's wizard balcony. Not sure where the S was there. Do we level up? No, but we're damn close. Okay. Up the stairs we go. Oh, this is the quest that I always confuse with the main quest. Anyways, we've leveled up. Let's go ahead and do that. One more point into health. Thinking like 300, maybe 250? Not sure. It's really hard to figure out what you want to do with a mage, you know? Was there anything special in Illusion that we wanted? Illusion spells work on undead, Daedra, and automatons. Would that even be helpful at all? No, because we're mainly just using it to hide and sneak. Okay, which means our next perk is once again going into the Conjuration Tree. Still can't increase anything. We could do Soul Stealer, probably Apprentice Conjuration. Yeah. You have to pretty much get those at some point, I think, to be able to deal enough damage. Alright, one more cast of Muffle and Invisibility, although I just realized there's no point casting Invisibility, but it's okay. I seem to remember that no one was in here, and I'm not even sure why we are sneaking, because we're invisible. We don't have to sneak. But I seem to remember no one is in this room at the moment, so I think we can freely walk around regardless. Could be wrong, though. Anybody in here? No? Okay, I happen to know that we want to take some charcoal here and maybe even, yeah, a roll of paper. And for anyone that hasn't played this game, you're like, why? But you shall see. Let's read whatever this book is called. Shemaravamidium? Reminds me of Shevaprama Dumrong, the producer for Family Guy. Okay. I don't think there's gonna be anything of worth in here other than that book. Doesn't look like it. Alright, once more. Muffle. And no invisibility because we're gonna have to activate something right here. Calcelmo's stone. Okay.
Accidents like this don't just happen. Someone is trying to sabotage my uncle's research.
Alright. If there is a thief, we won't leave this tower alive. Shouldn't we inform Master Calcelmo?
I'll deal with my uncle. Just go. Scour this place from top to bottom.
Sorry, guys. But I am out of here. Hopefully he doesn't see me. I don't think they can. I don't think the NPCs can see you in that split second. So, man, I know I've said this a billion times, but sneaky mages. Sneaky mages. Why is it telling me to return to Enthir, like, right around here, though? Well, let's fast travel to Markarth, I guess. Fast travel is currently unavailable from this location. No! Was there another way out? Can we just jump down? I don't think we want to do that. Oh, right. I think? Okay, well, regardless, we're gonna save the game here because I might just make a horrible, horrible mistake. I'm forgetting at the moment. But, no, can't jump over the edge. Maybe we can, but it's just up here. Oh, I understand now. Or do I? Okay, I thought it wanted us to jump over the edge into the... Oh, it does. Okay, that path is kind of hard to find. Into the waterfall. Yay! And we live. Yeah, really fun quest there. I like how they did that quest. You get the spider control rod, you get to sneak around. You get to jump into the waterfall like you're playing Assassin's Creed. A lot of fun. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to end this episode here. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys are enjoying this Let's Play. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.